and ready to match the stars. Bobby Vann, Elaine Joyce, Charles Nelson Reilly, Brett Somers, Richard Dawson, and Nanette Fabre, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rivers.
Hello there. Hello there. Are you ready? We've got a very lively bunch out there, Johnny Olson, and I thank you very much for being here with us to help us out. And we do need your help.
Okay.
Because without you, where are we?
Without our help.
You got yourself into that one, didn't you?
Yes, yes, yes. But are you all well and
no,
alive?
No, I feel terrible.
Sure.
Good.
Oh,
okay.
I'm well. I don't know whether I'm alive or not.
You're Would
not.
You say hello to Patrick Taylor and Sandy Simmons and greet them? Time, if you were with us, time expired just as we were about to start a game, and let's kind of refresh our memories and find out something about Sandy Simmons.
I will be a junior in the fall, majoring in sociology, and I'm going to be married in September.
All right, nice to have you with us, Sandy. Patrick, of course, is our champ. He's won $700, two games, and we'll start another game right after we start this, so stick around. Here we go. Round one. Sandy, as a challenger, would you make a selection?
A.
That's what she wants. Listen carefully, Sandy. Everyone will play, and this is it. The police commissioner said, I think Batman and Robin are blank. The commissioner said it.
Sort of narrows down, doesn't it?
Look how quickly we all finished.
Well, Charles just can't make up his mind.
Well, I made up my mind. That's what I'm going to write is what the problem is.
Shall I repeat it, Charles?
Okay,
the police commissioner said, I think Batman and Robin are...
Well, we're going to be
in the
Labor
Day. This
way
you get the full theme. It's quite lovely.
Okay. Now, Sandy, you think about it. The police commissioner said, I think Batman and Robin are...
queer.
I was
estimating by the panel. That's why I thought I would say that.
Are you sure you're going to be a junior in the fall?
What's that supposed to mean?
I don't know.
Couldn't you know, the moment I got my Robin outfit, a rumor like that would start.
Okay.
All this time.
Here we go. Her answer is
shame
clear. Bobby,
you.
What's yours?
You know, I just have... You're getting married soon, aren't you, Sandy?
Yes. Yes.
I just have Not anymore.
No, when she gets married, I realize her husband will be sleeping on a Simmons.
Sandy Simmons.
Anyway, just to redeem myself, I said queer.
Well.
Of course.
I love it.
Of course.
All right, Elaine, what do you have to say?
Right, the same thing.
That's it.
So far, we've got two queers.
That's right. I'll never forget it.
It just means they're a little strange.
Mr. Riley.
Well, I don't relate to that type of thing. And so
Thank
I put
heavens.
That they were always so pretty in their clothes that they were divine.
Divine. Miss Reticent, would you show us your answer, please?
I've never been so shocked in all my life.
Yes, John.
That pretty little girl saying words like that, yes. And those people behind me, I don't even want to discuss it. I said, lover.
Lover.
They were crazy about each other, honey. Everybody knew it.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Word gets around, doesn't it? What do you say?
Well, I understood, of course, they were good friends. And when the show went off, they got married. They're sick about it, folks.
OK, Okay, the answer she's looking for...
I wrote it in shorthand.
What does it mean?
Really?
That's what it says.
That's a man.
Just fairies.
You got
so, Sandy, you scored three times with that. Half the celebrities were matched
just
up there.
Just got yourself three quiz.
Now, Patrick's end of round one, and this is it. Everyone plays.
Oh.
It's easy to get blank in New York. It's easy to get blank in New York.
There's got to be an easier way.
Nanette is finished.
For once.
Easy.
We can't put... Oh, no.
Just neatening up the place a little there. Is everyone ready?
No.
No.
There was certain...
Oh,
okay.
Okay, now we're ready, since Brett is ready. And we will call on Patrick. It's easy to get blank in New York. How do you fill in that blank to match the celebrities?
Mugged.
Mugged. Mr. Lindsay will be unhappy to hear
that's
that.
That's right. Well, I never got mugged in New York, but I've gotten drunk in New York.
It's easy to get drunk in New York.
Okay. Oh. When was that you got drunk in New York?
After I got mugged. I can't say mugged because I live there. They'll hate me.
What do you say, Elaine?
Well, I live there and
she
they'll probably
care where
hate
she
me,
lives.
But I don't care. It's true. Mugged.
Mugged. Okay, there's one match.
I gave a simple lost.
It's easy to get lost in New York.
Oh. It is just a nice, quiet answer
streets
to keep the game
all
going.
Different directions, yes.
I said love.
Love. I see. All right. What do you say, Richard?
I'm ashamed of you. I said sexually fulfilled.
Oh, yes, it's class.
Okay. So, that's not a match, certainly. Nanette, what do you say?
I love New York, and I hope they'll take the message from all of this.
Mug. Okay. So you scored twice with that, Patrick. And that's the end of round one. Scores 3-2 in favor of our challenger, Sandy Simmons. And we'll go to round two right after this. Score 3-2 in favor of the challenger, Sandy Simmons, at the end of round one. So let's go to round two, and Sandy, make a choice.
This time I'll take B.
B is what she wants, and this is it. Last time around, you matched Elaine, Bobby, and Nanette, and now you'll be trying to match the other three. Here it is. John, so cheap, on his first date with Mary, all they did was blank. John, so cheap, on his first date with Mary, all they did was blank. Charles, Richard, and Brett.
Look how quickly I respond to the voice of authority.
Yes. Charles has just finished writing a book called War and Peace. Okay. Now, Sandy, we call for your response. John, so cheap on his first date with Mary, all they did was...
Park.
They parked.
Yeah. That's
all
usually
right.
What cheap guys do.
I see. She goes out. All right. Charles, may we see your response, please?
Yes, I was going to put park, Miss Simmons, but I changed it to watch TV, particularly the match game, followed by Secret Storm on most of these.
Thanks for the plug, Charles. That's
I
very
try
kind
to keep
of
it
you.
Going.
Now, here we go, Brett. Did they park?
Well, I couldn't. They sort of did. They sort of sat around and parked.
They sat around, yeah. No match there.
I got the buzzer, didn't
yes,
I?
Yes, you did. Richard?
The story of my whole ugly life.
Park.
Is the answer.
Hence the expression, talk is cheap. They talk.
They talked.
I don't get hostile. That's what they did. I'm merely telling.
All right. So there's no match there. It's 3-2 as we go to Patrick's end of round two. One match to tie the score. Two to win the game. Patrick, here we go.
Wait, mine says I still must
Well, now,
be right.
Wait a minute. He matched two people in the first time around. You were one and Elaine was the other. So
okay.
You two will not participate.
It's my fault. She left a call and I didn't wait.
I see. All right, for the rest of you, this is it. The musician blew so hard on his trumpet that his blank popped out. Bobby's ready?
I'm ready.
Everybody ready down here? No? Not quite. Okay. What, you can't get it in the slot there? Now it's all set. Okay.
His life.
The musician blew so hard in his trumpet that his blank popped out. Patrick, how do you fill in that blank to match the three, four celebrities that you're trying to match?
Well, his teeth or his dentures.
Teeth or dentures. Okay. All right, let's begin with Bobby Van.
Okay, I used to play a trumpet, and when I blew too hard, my eyes popped out.
Your eyes popped. Okay.
My teeth stayed in.
He's looking for teeth. Charles?
We're all looking for teeth.
I've got them. They're $9,000. I can bring another shirt.
Shirt pop right out there. All right, you need one to tie the score, Patrick. You're coming down the home stretch here. All right, Brett.
Well, I'm not a musician. I'm not much of anything. But I got a tummy, and if I played the trombone, it would pop out.
Tummy.
Tummy.
All right, now you must match Richard to achieve the tie. If you don't, we'll have a new winner there in Sandy Simmons. Go, Richard.
I shan't. Yes, he blew so hard that his shirt popped out
and did not match. So Sandy is the winner. Congratulations. All right, Sandy, we congratulate you. That's $100 for winning. We'll get to you in a moment, but we have to say goodbye to Patrick. He will leave us with $700, together with our thanks for being with us on Match Game 73.
Bye,
Patrick. Won the game, that gives you $100. It's a modest beginning, but you can go for $5,000 here now. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Billy Blank. Or Billy Blank. Now, the answer given most often by that audience is worth $500 if you can match it. The second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Now, we are allowed to enlist the aid of three celebrities in looking for answers, so choose one.
Bobby.
I'll say Billy the Kid.
Billy the Kid, he says. All right, let's get another one.
Charles.
I'd go with Billy Jack.
Billy Jack. Yeah. Audience likes that choice.
It's a and new
Richard.
Choice.
I mean, what's your third one?
Just
Richard.
Came out.
Billy Goat.
Billy Goat, he said.
Who lived next door to Billy Jack for about 2 weeks.
That's right. Until he couldn't stand the... All right. So you've got Billy the Kid, Billy Jack, and Billy Goat. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. But we need an answer now.
My first thought was Billy the Kid.
Billy the Kid it is.
That's right.
That's what we are looking for, the one that Bobby Van gave you. All right, here we go. We are looking for Billy the Kid. May we see the $100 response? Billy Goat is up there, the one that Richard gave you. All right, still looking for Billy the Kid. Here is the $250 response. Billy Jack is up there also, the one that Charles gave.
Very good.
Oh, it's so nerve-wracking.
Here it comes.
Cheer up, darling.
Here is. Billy the Kid is the one you're looking for. Here is the $500 response.
Yeah! Yeah!
Okay. Now, that makes you $500 richer. You're up to $600 now. Winning the $500, though, means you'll play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. But to collect the money, you got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. So please choose a celebrity now.
I'll stick with Bobby.
Ah, stick with me. That's good.
That makes three of us.
All right.
I should have said that.
Bobby Van, you get ready to write. You face me, Sandy, and here is the $5,000 question. Write your answer to this. Blank birthday. Blank birthday.
You don't get this. You're out of the gang. Okay.
Put it in there. Okay.
That's right. Let's
put it in the slot, and now we call for your response, Sandy. How do you fill it in? Blank birthday.
Happy birthday.
All right. For $5,000, Bobby, may we see your answer? Happy birthday! Now let's say hello to this pretty new player. Here is Beverly Ventimiglia. Everybody knows what that name means, but why don't you tell us?
20 miles, and we have a town named after us in Italy.
Okay. Where are you from, Beverly?
Van Nuys. I'm a native Californian.
And what do you do, if anything?
I'm a domestic engineer. I have a fantastic husband who's made me a golf widow for almost 10 years. I have three beautiful children, Denise, Dina, and Dino.
And you're a domestic engineer.
Right.
Came home three times, right?
Right.
Well, good luck to you here, Beverly. Are you ready to have a go at it?
I'm ready.
Okay, here we go. Round one coming up. The challenger makes a selection, so would you do that, please?
I'll take number B.
B is what she wants. We ask you to make the selection because some contestants find some questions harder than others. It's entirely up to you. Everyone plays. We have a new game beginning, folks. Here it is. Every morning, Snow White would blank the seven dwarfs. That's what it says right here. You don't believe me? Would you like to read it yourself?
Glasses on. Don't ask me questions.
That's it. Every morning, Snow White would blank the seven dwarfs. We're waiting, Charles. Ready? Okay. Now think about it, Beverly. There are your celebrities. Look into their eyes and dream up an answer you think will match their responses.
Well, every morning I have to wake my little dwarfs.
So you think Snow White wakened the seven dwarfs.
Yeah, awaken. All right. Get up.
Woke them up. Get out of bed, dummies. That's what she said. Okay.
There was only one dummy.
All right. Are you ready up there?
Yes,
Bobby?
I'm ready, Gene.
It's show and tell time. Show us your card. Her answer is wake.
Her answer is wake, and mine was feed.
Feed. Okay. Every morning, Snow White would blank the seven dwarfs. Elaine, what did she do?
One, two, three,
she counted.
And after she counted them, she washed them. Many people don't know the true names of the dwarfs, though.
Oh, really?
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. You figure that one out.
Okay. No match yet. She's looking for wake and
wake?
Brett.
She's looking for wake.
Wait, awakened or
wake.
Woke up
wake.
Or something.
No,
like
you
that.
Must never wake dwarfs. They get hateful and ugly, and they'll strike back, but you have to feed them.
Feed them. Okay. These are dwarfs, not trolls. What do you say, Richard?
I thought
I wish you'd tell me that before. So she gave him a little kiss in the morning.
Oh, kissed them up.
And then punched them right near their performance.
Well, that'd wake them up.
Well, that's how she awakened them. She kissed them.
She did kiss them. So, you didn't score with that at all. Let's go to the other half of this round, and this is it. Marcia called her mother at 3 in the morning and said, guess what, Mom? Milton and I are in blank. Marcia called her mother at 3 in the morning and said, guess what, Mom? Milton and I are in blank. Think about that one, Sandy. Charles is ready. Elaine is ready. So Sandy will call for your response. Guess what, Mom? Milton and I are in
Las Vegas.
Las Vegas. That's what she said. Bobby, what did you say?
I didn't say it. Well, while they were in Vegas, they were in bed.
In bed.
All right. I was trying to think like you, I'll tell you.
What do you say, Elaine?
Pittsburgh.
Charles,
can I change mine to Hartford? No, they were in jail.
Jail is his answer. Brett, what's yours?
Let's keep this show clean. Las Vegas.
Las Vegas. Okay. Richard?
They were in bed.
They were in bed.
And I'm ashamed of you.
Yes. They were sick of it. Nanette, what do you say?
Well, it doesn't matter where they were in trouble.
They were in trouble. So, at the end of round one, 1-0 in favor of our champ, and we've got this for you, and then you come back to us, okay? Okay, we've got to say goodbye temporarily. These two ladies, we'll see you next time, right?
Right.
Okay, we'll pick up exactly where we left off. And you will carry on next time, too, as you have been carrying on, because if I've ever seen a group that can carry on, it's you. I haven't seen your movie, but I understand you're quite good in it.
Thank you very much.
Have you seen
Lost
my movie?
Lost Horizons.
Lost Horizons.
No, I haven't seen your movie.
I didn't make one.
Okay.
I just did the life story of my manager. It's called The Thief.
All right, I guess it is time to say goodbye to you. We hope you'll be able to join us next time. Gene Mibbern here saying so long for Match Game 73. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are Carnival Weather, a completely portable gas grill that goes anywhere. Instant flame.